in a static partitioning, we know the value of partitioned column beforehand. We know that. But in dynamic partitioning, what is the value of partitioned column? That is something which is not known to us, and that is created dynamically. In order to see the partitions of a table, you can use the command show partitions. If you want to delete the partition, you can use alter table, and you can use whatever is the table name, and then you can give the drop partition, and then you can give the what partition you want to delete. So that partition, because partitioning will create a subdirectory in the SDFS. So that directory is going to be deleted. We are going to take some hands-on example over partition. First of all, you can see I'm going to create a table called as EMP details, which contains employee name, unit, experience, and location. And this thing we have already discussed. We are going to load some data into employee details. This is something we have already discussed. The difference is, suppose in our query, we are going to have lots of where clause on the location field. For different application, the access pattern is going to be different. In our case, suppose we are going to search on the basis of location. So we are going to create a table EMP details partition. This is my table, which will contain employee name, string, and experience. And finally, you will see it contains partitioned by location. So this is the new operation which we will explore now. So partitioned by means this table is going to, location is going to be the partitioned column. Now let us see how you can load into this table. First of all, figure it out, these two lines. You are selecting the employee name, unit, and experience from the EMP details. EMP details is a regular table. It is non-partitioned, where location is equal to Bhubaneswar, BBSR. And whatever is the result, that result is going to be written into this table, EMP details partitioned, the partitioned table we just created. And we have to specify the partitioned column and value of partition. So what do you think? This is a static partitioning or a dynamic partitioning? We know the value of the partitioned column, right? This type of partitioning is called as static partitioning, where we already know that this is the partitioned column and what is the value BBSR. Why? Because we are taking the data corresponding to BBSR only, and we are going to store that in the EMP details partition. So this is the static partitioning. If you would like to go for dynamic partitioning, one thing is which you have to see in mind is this property, the execution of dynamic partition mode, it is strict by default. You have to make it non-strict. Then only dynamic partitioning will be supported. And if you do that, see, you are selecting a star from EMP details. Now the EMP details, which contains the employee name, experience, and other things, so it can have location of BBSR. Some records may have location of Bangalore. Accordingly, other many records will have different values of location. So that is going to be dynamically decided by Hive, that which record will go to which partition. So we have to just give what is the partitioned column of the table, and it will get loaded into the EMP details partition. So this is how you load a particular table using query. One way to do that is using load local in path like that. Other way is to load from an existing Hive table using the query. Let us try to do these things to gain a little more understanding. So I'm already inside Hive. I'm going to drop this table, and I'm also going to drop table, the partition table, which might have got created earlier. So let us start afresh. Okay. So first of all, we are going to create the Hive table. Then we are going to load some data into the Hive table just to check whether it has been loaded properly or not. We are going to do a select star. Okay, any guesses how many MapReduce jobs are going to be launched if we do a select star? If you have tried this hands-on of Hive, you must have figured it out. How many MapReduce jobs get launched? Okay, let's see. I press and enter. What do you see? How many MapReduce jobs were launched? No, there is no MapReduce job. Why? Because it is simply reading. It is simply reading the file stored in the SDFS. That's it. So if you do a select star, that is not going to trigger any MapReduce. If you're doing some processing like count, maximum, minimum, average, these things,
then it is going to launch MapReduce jobs.
So you see the location part, some part is Bhubaneswar, some part is Bangalore, like that. We are going to create a partition table, which you can see this out here. And once we have created, if you try to see DESC, if you want to describe the table, you will see in the partition information, location is the partition column, which is of type string. And obviously these are the overall columns of the table. Now you want to load into, this is the static loading. So I'm going to get the details from the EMP details table only for the location BBSR. And I'm going to add all those records in the partition table with the partition key as the location, partition column, and the value as BBSR. So let that complete. Then we are going to discover the dynamic partitions as well. Okay, so it seems it has been loaded. Now I'm going to select a star from this table. Select a star from this particular table. So you will see only BBSR records are there. If you want to see the partitions, so you can use show partitions and table name. So you will see location is equal to BBSR is the only one partition which exists as of now. If you want to see this, the SDFS structure, that is also. So you see, this is my table location, SDFS location. Let us try to go there. DFS minus LS, and this is the location. You will be able to see a directory called as location is equal to BBSR. So directory has got created and the actual files will reside inside that particular directory. You see, this is the actual file which is inside that directory. Now, if you want to drop that partition, you can use alter table and then give the name of the table. And then you use the drop partition, and then you have to specify the partition column and the value of the partition column, that is location is equal to BBSR. So this is going to drop that partition. Now if you try to show partitions, you won't get anything because the partition has been dropped. And now if you try to select a star from there, you won't get any data. So this was about the static partitioning, which is not very much prevalent. Dynamic partitioning is very much prevalent and it is mostly used. So we have to specify that to be non-strict first, which is by default strict. And see, I'm not specifying the value of location. I'm just using location is the partition column. What is the value of that column? I don't know. That is going to be dynamically decided by Hive. Let's execute this query. It will do the MapReduce job internally. And then it is going to load that.
What are the partitions loaded? In our case, two partitions should be created, one for Bhubaneswar, one for Bangalore, because these are the two different values of the partition. And that is what has happened. You see, loading partition, you see, one partition this was loaded and one this was loaded. So Hive calculated that, like what are the partitions.
Let us go to the SDFS directory and see what are the directories. You will see one directory for location is equal to BBSR and one directory for location is equal to BNG. Two directories are created. You can also confirm by using show partitions. So you will see there are two partitions created in the table. And okay. And again, select a star, you will get the partition. So you will get overall record. But you can configure that for which partition you want to get data. So if your query involves where clause on the location column, your query is going to be much, much faster. So my question is, this is one query and this is one query. What do you think?
Which query is going to be efficient as compared to a non-partitioned table? This is my first query and the bottom one is my second query. Assuming that EMP underscore details underscore partitioned is partitioned on location. So what do you think, which query will be faster as compared to the non-partitioned column, a non-partitioned table? Name is equal to Aditya can be in any of the subdirectories, but location is equal to BBSR. There is a single subdirectory for this. So because our partitioned column is location and where clause also uses location. So that is going to be faster for partitioned table. Whereas the second query, it is going to be close to identical on both. It's not going to be drastically different across partitioned and non-partitioned tables.
One thing I would like to add is, if you remember the syntax of the load data, you will be able to appreciate that it contains load data. Local is optional if you are loading from local file system in path. path of the file, then where you want to store the data, and finally you can specify the partitioning information as well, that I want that this file should be loaded in this partition column or in this partitioned location. So you can specify that here. So dynamic partitioning is not supported with load data. Only static partitioning is supported. That is, you must specify that in which partition column you have to load that file. So you can do that as well. So that is, a static partitioning is supported here.
A cat killed. Average is dead.